How's it going, everybody? NerdRock here, and welcome to the first episode of Legend of Grimrock 2. I've been wanting to try this out for a while after it was recommended to me, so I decided to go ahead and get it and check it out. I played it a little bit, but I'm really just completely a noob at it. I was considering creating my own characters, because you get that option at the beginning, but then I realized that I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing, so I just went with the pre-made characters. I kind of wish we could have renamed them after the fact. That'd be cool, but oh well. So we got a Minotaur, we got a human fighter, we got an alchemist, and a wizard. So this is the same thing I tried when I just played it for a few minutes, so let's just get started here. How do I do this? Let me try to remember here. There we go. Just gotta hit this grate. Or not. Ah, here we go. Gotta give him a tool. Not looking good, right? I'm already stumped at the very beginning of the game. Alright, so let's look around, see what we could find. And hopefully I will just kind of learn this game as we go. Can I take this? Ah, good. Get some food. And please, if anyone watching is familiar with this game, please do not hesitate to give me any info, hints, and tips, because I will need it. Alright. We got a rock. This back guy here, he's going to be throwing stuff. Even though he's an alchemist, I don't know what else he's going to do other than throw stuff at people. So, that's what he's going to do. For those of you who aren't familiar with this series, this is the sequel of a game, Legend of Grimrock. And it's kind of like an RPG. It was a dungeon crawler. Now there's some outside spots, obviously. There's puzzles. There's all kinds of RPG elements. And it's pretty neat. I'm digging it so far. So, like I said, I have played this part already, so hopefully I won't get too stumped. Okay. Now's a good time to try to re-remember how these spells work. You get little patterns that teach you spells. I happen to remember that one. That gives you a fireball. Oh, and here's our first enemy. Here we go. Boom. Boom. And let's throw a rock at him. Okay, nice. So we got the rock back. Put that back there. Take the food. There actually is hunger in this game, I believe. Okay, let's open this door. Gotta hit this button. Nice. Alright, enemy number two. Bring it, guy. Bring it. So if any of you guys follow Notch on Twitter, you're aware that he has not stopped raving about this game since he got it. And that's a big part of why I actually wanted to try it out. I played the first one, like I said. I think I said that, actually. But I was quite bad at it. And hopefully this one I'll be a little better at, or maybe I'll get some help from some of you guys. Yeah, I'm a little disappointed that I could have taken the time to read about it, but I started reading about, like, how to make good class compositions. Nice, a key. And, honestly, it just went way over my head. So, I didn't think it was a good idea to try to... What are these, poison darts? Nice. I didn't think it was a good idea to try to come up with my own composition for the party. There were some things I really kind of wanted to try. Like, it would have been cool to have a battle mage. But, yeah, or a rogue. Because I don't have any of that stuff. But I really, like I said, I don't know the game well enough. So, I felt safe going with the pre-made party composition. So, that's what we're doing. And I'm sure it will still be a great time. I just didn't want to find myself in a situation where... Let me get this key. Nice. I didn't want to find myself in a situation where I got stuck because I'd made a very, very bad party. I'd like to actually be able to potentially beat the game. Although, I do reserve the right to rage quit. It's a very difficult game, so... Alright, we're going to throw this rock on that. How do? I just throw it? There we go. I kind of wonder, if I pick that back up, will the door close? I kind of want the rock back. I guess it will. Alright. Here we are. This game is beautiful, by the way. And you can tell you're on kind of like a grid when you move around, but it feels very natural. Let's go ahead and read this. Let's see. Dear visitor, welcome to my island. I hope your journey was... Sorry, my screen's a little far away. I hope your journey was not too detrimental for your health. I think you will find this island to be the most wonderful, yet the most perilous place on Earth. I don't have high hopes for your survival, but maybe you can prove me wrong. Better equip yourself before the night falls. All right. I don't plan on reading all of those. I get this weird thing sometimes. I don't know if it happens to any of you guys. Let me know. Sometimes I wake up, and when I'm looking at the screen, my eyes feel all funny. I don't know if it's just from spending too much time at the computer, or that I'm not fully woken up. I don't know. All right, let's fight this guy. Hey, buddy. Hit me in the butt. So as you can tell, the combat is not turn-based, but it kind of feels turn-based. It's weird. I can't explain it. It's definitely not turn-based, don't get me wrong. But it has... It doesn't have that, like, twitch feel like a game like Skyrim would have or something. Okay, Scroll of Fireburst. So let me show you how this works. Basically, when you get one of these, it'll tell you how to actually make the spell on here. So you've seen me using it already because I happen to know the pattern already, but if you don't, you can find those and they'll teach you how to do all the spells in the game, which I find pretty cool. And you can see here's our food level for all the characters. I'm gonna go have him eat some of that. I'll have her eat that as well. And I believe... Crystal of Life. Touch to heal wounds and restore dead champions back to life. And I guess there's a cooldown on it. That's good. And it saves the game as well. But I believe we can actually save the game manually with F5. Alright, we got another fight on our hands. This game is actually really, really complex, because as you level up, there's stats and there's all kinds of stuff, so it really, some very solid RPG elements. Very interesting game. Okay, so, what's cool is I happen to already know how to do, this particular, puzzle. But, the future ones are going to be way more difficult. One there. Okay, how are we gonna do this? Throw one. Oh, did I lose that? That would be lame. Oh no, I picked it up. Okay. So I don't like that you can't... If any of you guys know how, let me know. I don't know how you just pick up one of them. Yeah, because I'm gonna need a lot more of these. Alright, we're gonna have to look around for stuff to put on the ground, because I don't remember where I found all the things. Let me pick that back up. Alright. Basically, the puzzle here is you go over here and this thing tells you X marks the spot, so I gotta find items to make an X here. In the future, I will not know how to do all these puzzles and you will most likely see me rage. Me and puzzles are not good friends. We don't get along. Oh, here's some good stuff. Okay. We got knives. 3 throwing knives. That's gonna be great. Let's see what's behind here. Anything good? It's interesting. I actually don't think there's anything here at all. Here's this guy. I think we gotta put something in his hands, but I don't think he wants that bone. Alright, so let's look around a bit. Otherwise, I think I have enough stuff to throw down. Yeah, let's try it out. I'm gonna put these stuff down in an X. I don't know. How did I do this last time? Is there a way to split these items in the inventory? Whoops. Okay. Shift click. Ah, there we go. Okay, let's try this again. I'm hoping, if I remember correctly, I'm pretty sure... Pretty sure that once the thing is in, you can go pick up all the stuff again. Whoops. Oh, here's the other question. Let me try this. If I shift click... There we go! Awesome. Alright, let's pick up all that stuff. Yeah, great. Okay, because we want all that stuff. It's important considering it's the only attack this guy has is throwing things. He will also eventually be making us potions, which is pretty neat. Alright, all that's done. Let's go ahead through this little passageway we just opened up. Close this window. Alright. scary. Whoa. Luckily, I have a terrible memory, so it's almost like playing this for the first time. Awesome. That guy got kerploded. All right, this guy wants a piece, too. Bring it, buddy. Oh, there's two of them. Oops. I'm really looking forward to learning more about the magic system in this, because that's really, really cool. Oh, man. Oh, man, this guy's kicking my butt. Dart him. Fire him. Out of a cannon. Awesome. Get this stuff. That's going to be good for this guy. He needs all these things. Random little things we find, and he's going to use them to make us health potions and all kinds of goodies. Light this up. Out of energy. All right. So here, we probably need to do this anyway. Here's where we're going to rest. You hit the R button. Screen goes black, and all their bars fill back up. And done. And now it's nighttime, which means there's probably going to be some more enemies if we're going by what that little pamphlet said that we found earlier. A peasant's cap. Okay, let's put this on her. You know, you think with a name like Shadow, you'd think you'd be a rogue, right? Am I wrong? Alright. Go this way. Wingate Terminus East. Alright. Hit this button. Cool. Alright, go through the portal. Another one of these jerks. What are these things? They're like mutant turtle things. So I'm not really sure of the backstory of this game. I did play the first one a little bit. But I don't know. I don't want to say this because I don't know if it's the truth, but you start on a beach, so I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. I don't even know if this is supposed to be connected from the last game at all. I really should have probably looked all this up. Let's see. Ooh, this is a sling for stones. Alright, we're going to give this to our guy here. The other thing we're going to do is she's going to eat. Give one of these to him. He's going to eat. Give this to Rat Guy over here. Fang. And he's going to eat. Good. Alright. And I don't know about how good that sling is. Let's take a look. It, 3 to 10. And what does this do? Nah, it's much better. Alright, we're going to stick with the knives. Unless I'm missing something, but still want to stick with the knives anyway. Open up. How do I open this thing? Hmm. Oh, now I remember. One of these right there. And that shift clicking is a good thing to know. Pick this back up. And let's check out what's in here. Ornate key, that sounds important. A dagger. Let's give that to her for now. And a healing potion, we'll give that to her as well. Shadow. And let's continue on our merry way. We got some good stuff. We got a nice key. And I'm guessing we use the key to open this. Let's see. Yep, and we got another jerk. Awesome. Guy died really fast. Get knifed. Get knifed. Ooh, I got a critical. Alright, let's hit this jerk. Miss? How dare you miss? Nicely done. Let's see what's in this wooden box. We got smoked sea bass, a shovel, and I'll show you what that does in a second. A note. Let's see what this says. At the lone oak in the shadow of the blue light, I buried it. Ah, okay. I didn't read that last time I played, and we're going to give her this, this sword here. All right, we got to find the lone oak in the shadow of the blue light. Is it this? Huh, let's find out, okay? Now we're digging. Anything? Nothing. Do I gotta go back here? Here's the weird thing. Lights don't have shadows, they cast shadows. So that's a bit confusing. Let me read it again. The shadow of the blue light. Huh. I hate to leave this area without digging if it's here. So basically, you can dig around. That looks like an oak tree. You can dig around and potentially find stuff. And I guess you get these little notes that give you some clues. But it doesn't seem to be here, so I guess we're going to look around. Let's check back in here. I don't know. Let's Lone Oak, Shadow of the Blue Light. Nah, it's definitely not in here. Perhaps Shadow of the Blue... Nah, I don't know what that means. Although, let's check here. Can't. Okay. This looks pretty lone. Although, maybe I'm looking for a blue light. Not like... I don't know, I'm thinking blue light means, like, from the sky. But maybe it doesn't. That's kind of a dumb assumption. Okay. Look around a bit more before we go over there. What's over here? I'd like to try to find this thing if I can. And there is something I didn't try last time I was playing. So I definitely want to try that. Ah, the shadow of the blue light. It's gotta be right here. It's gotta be, right? This has to be it. Nothing. I mean, this looks kind of lone. And there's blue light. Nothing. Well, I gotta check around here, because it makes too much sense that this is where it would be. And once I move on, I don't think I'll be coming back, so... I really think it should be here. This is blue, right? Here's a lone oak. Here's blue light. Huh. I guess it's not. Alright, moving on. Here's the thing I didn't do. So, these statues with their hands out. Let me check right there, because maybe that's what was hidden behind that bush. Nope. Okay, so these statues with their hands out... I believe... Aha! Now when I take that off, does it stay open? Good, it does. Now what is here? A secret. A golden key. Now what could that be used for? Not here, is it? I really want to find something hidden underground. You know what, guys? I'm going to look around for a bit, and I'll be back in a sec. Alright, I realize there's actually one spot on this tree that I did not try to dig, and it's actually the most likely location, because, right, if it's in the shadow of the blue light, it should be on this side of the tree, even though the tree shadow is over there. So let's see if we find anything. And there it is! Awesome! I was looking it up, and I did see this tree, so I was like, alright, it's gotta be one of the spots. I don't want to make a habit of looking stuff up, but I knew there had to be one around here. An embalmer's robe. It's probably going to go on him, but we'll see what that does before we go ahead and use it. Let's see. Hidden pockets filled with tiny vials of putrid-smelling chemicals. Vitality and protection. Okay, no, this is going to go on this guy, because we're gonna level this guy up, I think, as our tank. Although, I'm not sure. Let's see what his stats are. Yeah, he's going to be something of a tank. She's going to be kind of an all-around fighter, I believe. Let's see, we got to level them up now. We got these skill points. Alright, so he's going to be more tanky than her, so let's level up her light weapon skills. And then we're going to level up his. See, I remember earth magic being really useful, but I also want to... I'd like to increase the damage his fire does before anything else, so let's do that. Now his fire is going to do quite a bit of damage. And we can move on to the next segment. In the future, I probably will be missing a lot of the secrets because this is not going to really be a walkthrough. This is going to be a let's play. Because I am not an expert at these kinds of games. In fact, I find them extremely challenging. So if anything, you guys are going to teach me. Let's see what this says here. The second most precious thing in life for a seafaring captain is his sword, because without it he cannot command his crew. Thus, upon losing his weapon somewhere on the shipwreck beach, he lost what is most important to him, the respect of his crew. Bummer. Okay, yes. I think this is going to be our first dungeon. Oh, yes. Awesome. Alright. Let's read what this says. Halls of the Dead. Want to be thorough and look around before we go anywhere. Broken wall. I'm actually a little concerned with how this is going to look on YouTube. YouTube is not really good with dark video. And there are people out there that I guess have learned how to... Ooh, scroll of shock. Ah, we need air magic for that. But we'll hold on to the recipe anyways. More health for her. There are people on YouTube I've noticed that have learned how to deal with it. Lockpicks. Awesome. I feel like that should go with the rat guy. But I have not learned how. I think it has to do with using a different codec. I think you want to use like WMV or something. But I have no experience with that. So hopefully it just looks fine the way I always do it. If there are parts that are a little dark, just know I will do the research and find out how to fix it. Unfortunately, it's really hard to see how it's going to look on YouTube before it's uploaded to YouTube. Which is weird, but that's the way it is. Boom! Alright, the sword is a nice upgrade. We never actually even looked at the stats on it, did we? Maybe we should. Hold on. Let's take a look at what this sword does. Oh, that's right. I gotta close that. The sword. 4 to 13 Whoa. What's hitting me? Get out of here, jerk. This guy's a jerk. Oops. Come on. Alright, awesome. One thing I could say I'm not doing enough of already is saving. I should be saving way more often. Awesome. Okay, this guy does not need any of these stuff anymore. He's gonna have a gun now, which is just super cool. And he has leveled up, so it's time to check this out. We're gonna level up his firearm skill for sure. And I just wanna check, there's nothing else that I need to do, right? Okay, good. Let's level up our Minotaur here. And we're gonna go with Athletics, because Athletics is going to increase his health and his carrying capacity, which I'm sure is going to be extremely helpful later on. And we found a button. Let's press it. Doesn't look like it did anything. Let's try this. Alright, and now I hit the button. There we go. Now that I just did that, I actually remember that from last time I played. Alright, now this is probably a good time to rest our characters, get them back to full health. That's good. And I'm gonna save it. There's like a hardcore mode where you can't save. Unless you're at one of those crystals. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna give this guy a torch, put away a shovel. This way it should stay bright enough for the YouTubes. Thought I saw something moving around back here. Guess not though. Iron key. Man, we got a lot of keys. Alright. We should probably get rid of that. Let's just throw it on the ground. Oh, what's this? Poison cloud. Wow, I almost missed that. Alright. Take this. Toss it. That's enjoyable to me for some reason. You know, the last game I played that was like this was Might and Magic Legacy. And I like this quite a bit more, actually. Oh boy. Bring it, guys. Bring it. I'm going to shoot you in the face. Boom, I shot you in the face. What you going to do now? Uh-oh. He's gonna hit me. All right. I just had a thought, too. I'm going to try something out after this fight. Miss? This guy's got to work on his shooting skills. Alright, I want to try something now. Can I do this? And switch mid-battle? I don't know if the cooldown just... It probably doesn't make a difference. I'll leave that there anyways. And let's go ahead and put his shovel in number 2. Oh, he's not wearing this. Put that on. Okay, and also put his health potion at number 2. And let's do the same thing with her. And that way, this should be in his inventory. And this way, I could just switch to two and heal them if I need to. That sounds pretty good. The Horn of Summoning, and you will see what this does really soon. Let's go ahead and heal them up. And awesome. All right. We have emerged from the depths. Hit the button. Where is that? Over here. Okay. All right, we're back here. Okay. Let me show you where we're going to go next. And then just a few feet, basically, after this area is where I played to. Maybe a little further. I don't fully remember, but... Yeah, not too much further after this is where I'm going to basically be clueless. And let me just show you what the sign says over here. Welcome to the location of your first challenge. When you are ready, stand in the circle and call out the guardians. And that note's from the Island Master. So I guess, I don't know, it reminds me of kind of like the Riddler. We're stuck on this crazy dude's island. So we're going to, that's what this horn we just found was. We're going to sound the horn. I guess I have to equip it. Let's let this guy do it. Oh boy. Oh, I should have saved. Ah! Why didn't I save? Okay. Miss? There's no missing. So what's important when fighting this guy is to not get cornered. I kind of learned that last time when I fought him. Ow. Also not to be a total, like, dummy like I'm being right now. Alright, come on, fight. Oh, and I dodged that one. That was good. So I believe... to some degree, these two share a health bar. Oops. Alright. Well, it's a big moment. Why am I... I'm really choking right now. Come on, come on. Okay. I want to give this to this guy. Uh-oh. Act faster. Act faster. Alright. I don't know if that was the best choice, but I did it anyway. Come on, come on. Oh no. Oh no, okay. Not doing well. Why did I... Oh boy, he doesn't have a weapon anymore. There we go, okay. Sorry guys, I'm derping. I got very nervous all of a sudden for some reason. Okay, almost got this guy. The rat might die. Alright. Come on. That hurt him. Gun jammed. Whoa, that's not cool. Unjam it. Alright, I'm gonna switch the knives. We've lost the mage. That is not good. Okay, we're gonna heal our main fighter. I don't wanna risk dying here. Oh man, we're cornered. There are definitely people watching right now just facepalming at how bad I am. Yes! Yes, we did it. There's all kinds of stuff on the ground. Okay, I'm gonna take this. Not quite sure what it does. And what did we just pick up? Looked like there was something else on the ground there, but... Oh, she has... Huh, alright, well we got that gem. Let's see. A beautiful gem that radiates light in the colors of the spectrum. I don't know if this do anything. Doesn't seem to. Oh, and you can throw this. I never knew that you could throw this. Hold down the attack button. Alright, well, let's get back our mage first, because staring at that skull right over here is making me really depressed. We want to get him back to life. All our health is back. And, we should be ready to move on. Yes, the doors have opened. Awesome. Alright, guys, well, that should do it. Next episode will be here, and I'm just about at the point where I stopped playing last time I tried it. So from here on out, just about, it's all new to me. So I hope to see you guys next time. Wednesday is going to be Legend of Grimrock Day. Potentially Fridays as well. I'm going to try it out. I'm not sure, but Wednesday's for sure. And yeah, if you guys like the episode, please go ahead and leave a like. It's very important for new series because I like getting kind of an answer from my viewers whether or not they're enjoying the new content or not. So let me know if you've enjoyed it. If you're not subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe if you want more of these videos. And I will see you guys next time. Peace.